하이션.
And make sure you know this one.
Green.
No, this one, yeah, cool. So, good evening everyone, and thank you for attending here. So I'm Anubhav Kirk and I'm standing up for the post of EUSC Court. So because we are a bit constrained for time, I will just quickly take you guys to my manifesto, which I have prepared for the same. So, as EUSC, so I've been a part of EUSC, and there's one thing in particular I've noticed during my tenure here. So EUSC is a relatively new club. It has been 3 years since it was founded, and because of that, we have focused a lot on outreach activities, maybe a bit more than what we should have, because we needed the visibility, we needed people to know about us, and we needed to grow bigger. Because of that, I have received feedback that the original purpose of EUSC, which was to work for the DA students, is, you know, has somewhat been backtracked a bit. So if elected, this is something I hope to change to really make sure EUSC works for the DA community. Other than that, I've kept the mission objective to be broadly similar, but at the same time, I've come up with initiatives to really try and, you know, improve on the work we have done so far. So the structure of EUSC, which was devised by the second court, as you can see, I'm going to continue follow up with this structure, and I'm hoping to really segregate and divide up the responsibilities even better this term. So for the outreach cell, what I am I'll just come here. It just paused. No, it actually just vanished.
Just pause it.
Yeah, so for the outreach cell, these are the initiatives which we have worked on so far and which I hope to improve on. So this year we started a really aggressive, a somewhat aggressive social media campaign, which I hope to take forward as well. I hosted EOST's first speaker session, and the feedback we received was that it was pretty good. So I hope to organize more such speaker sessions and events at the same time. And regarding our newsletter, while we have published a couple of newsletters, they weren't published as often as we would personally have liked because of some resource constraints, which I hope to tackle. These are the new initiatives which I am hoping to propose. So Dinner in the Dark is kind of like a traditional UFC event which was held during the second tenure again, and this is something I'm hoping to revive here. Experience DA is something I've personally been a part of during my undergrad, and I will be happy to take this forward with you guys as well. And of course, education, also BPA is the Blind Persons Association, which is in the neighborhood of IMA, and EOSC as a club has some regular interactions with it. So I hope to take that interaction further by really contributing to the community. Now regarding the other two initiatives, which are going to be my main focus point, I will start with student support. So as of now, each DA student is appointed a mentor in EOSC so that, to enable a smooth integration in their academic and residential life. This is something I again hope to take forward as well as improve upon. For ACADS, while there are a lot of avenues available to the students of IMA, I hope to go one step further and hope EOSC can maybe be a platform for DA students to come and bring all their doubts or any uncertainties which they may have. And of course, because this is such a huge campus and there are so many power structures involved, we have the SAC, we have the PGP office, we have a separate DA office. I hope that EOSC can be a platform to really bring all these authorities together and collaborate. For the new initiatives which I am proposing, so as of now, each DA student receives the soft copy of the course material, which is mailed to us. However, we do not receive any soft copy of the books. Instead, we have the provision where we can divide up the bulky books, so that is easier for us to carry. But we still have to come all the way to the publication division for this purpose. So I'm hoping that if not the entire books because of copyright purposes, but at least the relevant readings and the questions are scanned and mailed to us. So there are some professors who did mail us the e-books, so I'm hoping that this is something we are able to take forward. So regarding the faculty interaction, again, this is just something I feel can make the students feel more at ease if they have a faculty or even the DA office authority. Something which they are, they can interact with, a formal figure of authority they can bypass the student's bodies with. While I know this may not be a proper idea because EOSC and SAC exist for the student community, but at the same time, I feel that even a simple faculty interaction can go a long way to, really support the students. And online support, so from what I know, IMA does not have any online support in its website which details the facilities which the DA students have access to. So if you go to IIM Bangalore's website, they have a full separate page for this. We at the AOSC have already forwarded the material to CCC to integrate in the IMA website, but I am hoping to ensure that it gets implemented and taken forward. So regarding the last step, we have accessibility, and I feel this is one of the major concerns for the DA students. So as of now, AUST works across these three areas. So infrastructure is something which has been a regular pain point for the students here. And while I know this is the impact which AUST makes may not be as much as we would like to, I still feel that this is something we should continue taking forward. For the academic, like I mentioned, we would love to have the soft copy of the e-books, but at the same time, I'm hoping that we're also able to provide the placement support for the DA students. So regarding this, Placecom does have a separate policy, but this is not something most of us were aware of during our own internships. And finally, for technology, while I wasn't able to elaborate in detail in manifesto, I have a couple of points I've thought of, and I would like to take these forward with you as well. So for the new initiatives, as we are all aware, a student forum was inducted this year. I hope that we are able to add an accessibility thread in this forum where the students can just complain about any infra-related problems they are facing. They can be something like probably a lack of flashlights near the old campus. So whenever the DA, whenever any student, or especially the DA students who are you know, traveling to the old campus, they have regular complaints about the lack of vision, you know, the lack of accessibility. And there are, but this is something which, if it, you know, like if a light is malfunctions, this is not something you get to know straight away. So I hope the forum can actually help us take this forward. Regarding the surveys, we as AOSC did conduct a survey at the start of the term, but we weren't able to take that forward because we received a lot of input from these surveys, and I guess we were a bit overwhelmed with it. So this year, I am hoping to have a more periodic survey so that we are also able to receive feedback on the work we have done so far and improve upon it. Finally, a constant complaint I received from every DA student is the lack of medical support. So as you may be aware, most of the DA students live in dorms 28 to 33 because, you know, that's where they have individual bathrooms, they are able to, they are really providing the smooth integration for the residential life there. However, the dispensary is in the old campus in dorm 10, which is a huge distance. And I've received personal feedback that when a DA student falls ill, then it's very hard for him or her to actually travel all the way. So I have some, again, proposals to improve upon this, which I hope to take forward. This is a team structure I'm proposing, which is going to be largely unchanged. So this is the planned activities timeline, which I have thought about. So again, the mentorship program will start when the new batch comes in. In December, we will have the International Disability Day, which is kind of like a flagship event. I hope to have monthly meetings with all the relevant authorities. I hope to continue the Vision in the Dark and the AOSC newsletter in the bi-monthly manner. So Vision in the Dark has been one of our most successful initiatives, and we always receive a full house initiative, you know, full house whenever we roll it out. But we haven't been able to roll it out as many times as I would have liked, so I hope to take this forward as well. For team wise, for term wise, we are going to have regular meetings with the SAV and the publication department, especially the publication department, because the course material and the books will depend upon that. And finally, regularly, I'm going to make sure that we keep up to date on our social media outreach and the student support. So this is the budget which I'm proposing. I'm not going to go in very much in depth with that, but if you have any question, then you can ask me about it. Finally, these are my credentials. So, as I mentioned, I've been the current member of AOSC team, and I have taken charge of various activities and initiatives in AOSC, including our first ever speaker session. I've also been a former executive in Mathematics Society, IIT Delhi, which means I have experience in organizing large events, and I also have experience in managing a team as well. Finally, I have done a lot of social work, which includes teaching underprivileged students and working on a couple of road safety initiatives. I've also collaborated with multiple NGOs, and I hope that my time there can contribute in my future tenure if elected as AOSC. Thank you, that's all from my side. And sorry, which one? Which new initiative?
Experience DA.
Yeah. So I will start with telling you what I experienced, because it is going to be large part going to be emulating that. So for example, what happens is you blindfold a person and you hand him a walking stick, or him or her a walking stick, and you basically have him walk around in some specific areas where you have different tasks set up. So the tasks we had involved were, and these tasks are pretty simple day-to-day tasks. It can be something like identifying the difference between salt and pepper by smelling them. Right, so if you can't see, then you're actually going to have to smell or taste. It can be something as simple as typing your name in a keyboard. So most people aren't aware, but the keyboard actually has provisions to ensure that any visually impaired person can find his way there. For other disabilities, I think you did, for example, if someone has a hearing problem, or if you want to experience that. So what I thought was, if we could have early morning walks with an earmuff on, so that you can just experience walking around the campus without hearing any sounds. So I believe this is an initiative which will increase the empathy level among the community, while at the same time, this is not an initiative which will require a lot of effort from our side. It actually just requires us to take the initiative.
Also, regarding various events that we conduct, for example, speaker
session. In this experience, DA only or in general?
In general.
So in general, other than the speaker sessions, The quizzes have again been a very popular success, which I am hoping to take forward. One specific initiative will be the articles. So what we are hoping to do is, in the AUSC newsletters, we actually publish the articles we have had, the really good articles. So if we are able to have more bi-monthly article tournaments, then that will encourage us to get out more high quality newsletters in a more, you know, frequent manner. Other than that, we have also come, I am hoping that we can come up with some initiative during chaos, not this chaos because we don't have a timeline for that, but maybe next year I am trying and hoping to, you know, just get that additional player in.
Regarding this education, collaboration with NGOs, okay. So again,
this is something I did during my undergrad. So in my undergrad, we had NAB, which is the National Association for Blind. And what happens is there are students who are in, you know, who are going to give their board exams, or basically students below the 12th class. And it's so what we do is we provided one-to-one coaching to them for subjects like mathematics or physics. And this was a purely like education initiative. We didn't receive any NSSRs or, you know, any CV points or anything. It was something we did because we wanted to do it. And I feel that there it was a quite a popular event because, you know, other than increasing empathy, this was like for people who genuinely want to contribute, they were really happy with that. So I'm hoping here if we are able to at least give the opportunity to our community to do something similar, then why not?
So just a small clarification. So we do have the facility of delivering the books from the publication to the book.
No, actually, this is not something I am planning to encourage even. So the reason for that is you are asking for delivery from publication office to the DA, right? So what I have noticed, most of the DA students either ask their friends to do it, or they can just most of them ask their friends to do it actually. So the soft copy which we have provided, it is actually pretty comprehensive and pretty good. I personally prefer to study from that. So my complaint about my only complaint was about the books, which we weren't really provided the soft copies of, and anyways we had to get them. So like what most of my friends do, they like for example, you have the FM book, the Coffin book. Yeah, you divide it into different parts, and then they just carry those relevant parts to the class. So you still have to just, you know, carry it from the publication house, but at the same time it becomes easier for you to carry it all the way to the class.
Like, I get the point, but if you like this facility available, like this term and the books are being distributed, you can actually drop them in and then deliver it to
them. It's not that I'm not willing to do that. My point is that I'm hoping that the situation doesn't come to that.
Yeah, that's
so.
Also, one more thing. So you talk about providing medical support and staff.
Yeah.
So have you thought, like, you all understand this problem is there, so there should be a dispensary in the new campus. I think everyone here would be agreeing.
Yeah.
Like, how do you propose?
Okay, so right now we have two doctors in a dispensary, and both of them work in like one shift each, one in the first half and one in the second half. So what we thought of was, what if say one doctor will stay in the SAB in the first half, and the other doctor stays in dorm 10 in the first half, and the other stays in dorm in SAR in the second half. So what I thought was, if someone is ill, like if someone has a fever, for example, in the morning class, and he's in the old campus, he can anyways go there in the dispensary which is close to him.
Just asking the doctor over here, you need the other equipment instead of the SAR as well, you need the medicine over there.
Yeah, but what I was thinking was, we basically need a dressing room and we need a like a small office for the doctor's side.
We have had a couple of interactions. We did a meeting with all the stakeholders, and the biggest challenge was what they came up with. We don't have the space. We need officially the space to provide it by the campus, where the doctor can sit with the entire setup. So that is the secondary challenge of actually having someone to sit there. The current challenge which we are facing is, we haven't been able to finalize a space in the campus where the doctor can come. Just okay. Keep you updated on that. So it's not that they can come and sit anywhere in the SAB. Like, we need a proper room, a dispensary to actually where the doctor can come. That's the current challenge which we are trying to solve. But as of now, there has been no decisive approach on that.
Yeah, so other than that, yeah, then that sounds like a valid issue, but I hope that You know, even ESG can be a part of the discussion, because we have a last day, because most of the DA students have directly come to me and complained about this, and I just tried to think of the measures, and this measure which I just proposed was you know, recommended by one of them, that you just have two shifts because that works. But regarding the space criteria, is I was a part of EOSC for the past year, and I believe this really gave me a, you know, hands-on working with what we have been doing and what needs to be done to actually improve on our work. Another thing is, I personally talked with our past EOSC coordinators as well. So I've talked with them, I've talked about the vision they had for the club when they nominated it, about the work they have done and what were the problems during their time and how they improved that. And I've been trying to draw parallels to make sure that the club progresses and, you know, innovates so that it is able to accomplish its actual task of working for the DA students in campus. So my point is that I have researched a lot, I've worked a lot, and even if I'm not deputy coordinator, I still intend to apply for this club anyways. So I actually just want to contribute further to this community, and I feel that being a part of the EOSC community will help me do a lot more than just a member of it.
What's your vision for this club?
Sorry?
What's your main goal, like two main things or vision for this
club? The main goal I have is working for the DA community also. So this is the feedback I received, that you are focusing too much on the outreach areas. And this year, the DA student told us, like, the EOSC mentor we were appointed. So I'm a DA student myself, I was also appointed a mentor, but we never really reached out to them. For some reason, whenever we had any issues, we reached out to the academic mentors, we reached out to our dorm seniors, to our maybe section seniors. But for some reason, it never came to our mind that EOSC was a platform we could further approach to, you know, try and resolve our issues. And I feel that this is something, this is a mindset which we can improve upon. So while we have done some really good work in the outreach cell, I want to improve and really bring the student cell and the accessibility cell to power.
Okay, thank you.
So we have 10 minutes and the house will give you the reason and the 10 minutes are also.
Oh, sure. Yes, sir. So hi, I'm Shaunak, I guess all of you know me. So
can you give me my
okay, sure.
So I guess all of you know, so no need for introducing myself, so let's get started. So yeah, the objectives of EOS cell are making IMA a more accessible campus. Secondly, sensibilizing the IMA community in terms of the contribution of the differently abled in our society. So currently people usually consider differently abled to be physically deformed, and there are various other deformities, like there are 21 different classes which are identified by the Indian government, and like hemophilia, thalassemia. So we need to sensibilize them in a more better manner so that they can consider these as well. And working with various stakeholders to support the different level students in the IMA campus and deal with specific issues of different level students related to academics, placement and any related activities. So the team structure, so there are three cells, the outreach, student support and accessibility. So there will be about 10 to 15 PGP1 and FFPM1 and 10 to 15 PGP2 and FFPM2. About 5 second years in each of the three cells, with the coordinator directly managing all the three cells. So let's go to the outreach cell. So the letters in bold are my new initiatives, and the rest I'm going to continue in this year as well. So firstly, we wish to communicate all the activities and events with the social media platforms and sensitizing the forthcoming batch regarding the various activities. And also, there is an event on International Day for Persons with Disabilities we can have as done this year, last year, that is the poster making competition, the article writing competition, as well as opinion wall. So there can be speaker sessions as well, which are written as well. And the organizer of Vision in the Dark event through the Blind People's Association nearby our campus. And organizing the Dinner in the Dark event, this event was done about 2 to 3 years ago. Of course, it hasn't been done, so we need to do that as well. And running an online weekly newspaper on the website and emails. And then faculty involvement, there is no faculty involvement currently, so faculty involvement is the Equal Opportunity Community Forum, and working with MAD to make a film and IMAX to make a play on different tables students. Now the student support cells, so we can have regular meetings. Of course, at least once in a week, and meeting with administration to resolve specific issues. The mentorship program was already installed, but we need to have one-to-one mentor allocation for proper resolution of the issues. And the main important point is the placement-related activities. Currently, different level students need to know what to say and what not to say during an interview. And I've faced lots of interviews, so I think even lots of PGP2 have faced it, so they'll be better able to tell these things. And as well as we are gonna have a CV review as well, simply because there are various students in during our internship that we saw that people who wanted to go to a certain domain was not able to go to the domain simply because his or her CV was not matching for that domain. So that's, we need to have a good CV review as well. For the mock GD and interviews, some students might not be able to make it to the place where the coordinator of the club are conducting the GD and interview. If such is the case, so we will talk with the SAC and the club coordinators and organize an area where the student will be able to go. And arranging for special assessments prior to the student's arrival, so we will mail and call the students. If any special requirements are required, so we can make that as accessible as well. And the delivery of books, so during term one of the person who is a physically disabled person, so what happened is he went to collect the books in the old campus, took an Uber and came to the new campus, because all the different levels are in the new campus. Even in this term, he has called the publication department and they said that they will take about 250 to 300 rupees for transferring the books. So that needs to be done in a proper manner. And again, because of the access issue, so I'll make sure that the doctors are available in the new campus as well. Now coming to the last cell, that is the accessibility cell. So working with the PGP office and the publication division and SAO office on issues related to the draw allocation as well as accommodation. And the seat allocation, all the students are currently allocated the wells, but there are certain students who doesn't prepare to sit in the well for all the 3 terms. I've talked to various students and they said that only for those students who are not able to climb the stairs, maybe for them allocation of seats in the wells should be done and not for everyone. And making classroom more accessible, which can be done by sharing of PowerPoint presentation to specific students by the professor prior to come to the class. And finally, the room delivery of mess food is needed for specific students. So this is the timeline and the budget that I've decided. So about 1 lakh for the dinner in the dark event and 90,000 for the event, Paris events in the International Day for Persons with Disabilities and the speaker sessions. And these are my credentials. Sure.
Are there any current events
that
you're planning to not continue?
I've seen all the events, and all the events are quite well organized, I think. I'm not a part of the USSL right now, so I think that all the events have been done quite well in a good manner. So I want to control all the events.
So regarding this is
actually all the PGP1, FABM1, PGP2 and FABM2 members who are differently able. So we are a community, obviously. So any special requirement, I mean, the faculty might be able to guide us in a better manner. So obviously, involving a faculty for certain issues might be useful. So I'm not sure whether that will be required or not, but that might be useful. If in certain situations, I may not be able to solve an issue, maybe reaching out to a faculty who is a part of the USSL will be better, I think.
The
faculty will not be regularly involved. We will be only the case if it is
basically USSL and the faculty.
Yeah.
Why are you calling it a community board?
So we are the students. All the students of the person with special needs are a community basically, because we are a group of community. Even I am in the community, so that is why.
Yeah, we have 2 questions, so just 1 clarification. That please do send me the number of the person who asked for money, because the institute is supposed to deliver the books for free.
Sure.
And this time we did it, got it delivered. And we did not do that. Just to clarify, so if anyone that you come to know,
sure.
Ask money, just let us know, because the delivery is supposed to happen. Okay, and secondly, you talked about providing medical support in the new campus, right? Medical facility,
if we can.
So, have you given it a thought, like, how about a problem, road blocks?
So, obviously, arranging for a chamber will be a roadblock, but that can be done.
Have you thought about the location there, like,
what I thought about is that the doctors currently are in the old campus, and if any specially able student falls sick, he or she can call the doctor's chamber and the doctor can come to a dorm if the need be. Because there might be only 1 student in a month. So obviously making a chamber won't be suitable. So yeah.
You had an initiative where you said you want to have a meeting once a week for all the DA students, right?
For the club members, and if there need be, the DA students as well. Yeah.
So, like, the club is okay, but do you think it's feasible for you to call all the people for a meeting?
Obviously, obviously not everyone will come. I'll try my best. So, Yeah, so if there is, as I've said that if there is, we are gonna use the Kona method to share online newspaper through email. So obviously for that we need to meet at least once a week. And if there are any other issues that crop up, obviously for that we need to have a meeting. So yeah.
Like right now also, even if the newspaper has any kind of issues, they can directly communicate via WhatsApp or email.
Yeah, that is that. Right.
That you don't need to meet.
I said that if a need arises, but I mean a special type of need, but the DS students need to be involved as well. So that is a separate thing.
Give me an example.
It won't be easy, like
even
for the class, I try to have a class meeting every month.
So for the newsletter thing, maybe.
Maybe you will have delegated responsibility every week for the newsletter.
Yeah. Maybe and what did you say,
Siddharth? Could you give me an example? The information that there would be some special needs or special events that the people would need to meet. So, could you give me an example of such an event?
Such an event hasn't happened in IIMA campus, but the Indian government had such an event. So, I'm going to give an example of Ms. Siddharth Sinhal. She was a pass out of FMS Delhi. She used to work in Coop, and they decided that she wanted to do something different for the community. So she gave UPSC exam, and during the first time, and she stood first. And what the Indian government did was, we are going to provide you with all sorts of support, or the money will come to your house as well, but you won't be able to serve as an IAS officer. And she made a court case, and in the next year, she stood first, and she is currently the IAS officer of probably North Delhi.
One last question, why do you want to buy out the other companies?
So, I have done various activities at my credential source, and I wanted to go into the film club, obviously, because I have a history of filmmaking, and you have seen that I was the founder of the film club as well. But then again, I saw certain things that the OEC needs to be developed in a more better manner. So that is why we.
Can you tell the approximate number of people who tend to be
meeting? Five PGP, two FMM2, and around totally 5+5, but obviously, that number might shrink. That is the maximum number.
Usually, outreach cell has the most amount of work.
So, we keep around 50% people in outreach cell
right now. Okay, so that can be changed, yeah. Because the problem with mandate for the students is right now that these students don't approach the mentors.
I've listened to that, I think that, yes. So,
what do you think that?
So probably what I can do is I can have communication with them prior to the coming on campus, and on the first day in campus I can arrange it, because on the first day everyone will meet me. So obviously on the first day in campus I can have a talk with them, have a meeting with them, and specify the needs in a better manner.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.